The Kingdom of Lesotho is certainly one of the lesser known countries in Africa. It is tiny, but it's a gem of an enclave. It earned the name Kingdom in the Sky due to its mountainous terrain. It is the world's highest country, and no part of it lies below 1,400 meters above sea level, meaning it has the highest, lowest point of any of the world's nations. Its mountains and valleys are peppered with horsemen wearing conical straw hats and traditional Basotho blankets made from goat fur. This country established the world's first nation-to-nation twinning with Wales due to similarities in size, landscape, bilingualism, and cultural heritage. Lesotho is located in the Southern African region and has no borders with any other country but South Africa, meaning it is completely surrounded by South Africa, which, just like San Marino and Vatican City, makes Lesotho one of the only three countries in the world to be completely landlocked inside another single nation state. With just over 30,355 square kilometers in size and a population slightly over 2 million, which, compared to South Africa, a much bigger country, is 40 times the size, 26 times the population, and 160 times its economy. It got me wondering, how come this constitutional monarchy preferred to stay as a separate entity? Well, turns out this isn't the case. Since before independence in 1966, there have been several campaigns to have Lesotho relinquish its sovereignty and accept rule from Pretoria. The latest appeal came in 2010, as the then World Cup host South Africa secured its borders ahead of the tournament, barring thousands of people from Lesotho from crossing its borders. Huge numbers of protesters, part of the Lesotho People's Charter Movement, marched through the capital Maseru and delivered a petition to Parliament and the South African High Commission requesting that their country be integrated into its giant neighbor. The petition read in part, "We have 30,000 signatures. Lesotho is not just landlocked, it is South Africa locked. There is no reason for us to exist any longer as a nation with its own currency and army." I'm not sure if this has ever happened in other parts of the world. Let me know in the comments if it's happened before. For all intents and purposes, this was a request by citizens of a country to another country to, in effect, annex their state. While the argument for scraping its borders and incorporating the mountainous kingdom as South Africa's 10th province is compelling, to better understand Lesotho, you have to go back in history to the early days of the 19th century, when a couple of things happened simultaneously in Southern Africa. Basotholand, as Lesotho was known, was founded by King Mashoeshoe in 1820 through unification of various groups in efforts to repel territorial challenges and military conflict with the Zulus, at the time led by King Shaka. During this militarized period, populations of many chiefdoms were annihilated, dispersed, or incorporated into stronger, reorganized, and larger chiefdoms positioned in strategically advantageous areas. Meanwhile, Britain had wrested the Cape Colony from the Dutch, and many disgruntled Boers from Dutch origin left the colony to settle north of the Orange River on what was, according to them, ostensibly empty land. This put the Boers on a collision course with the Basotho, whose land bordered or overlapped with where the Dutch moved to. Decades of conflict ensued. Threatened by the attacks and plunder of the Boers, King Mashoeshoe entered into a treaty of alliance and protection with the British government in 1843. The treaty provided for protection in the event of aggression by an outsider, and that the Basotho were to continue to exercise complete sovereignty over the region. However, more hostilities broke out in 1865, with the Boers laying siege to Taba Busiu, a mountain stronghold that acted as the capital. Fearing defeat, Mashoeshoe made further appeals to the British for assistance, and Queen Victoria agreed to place the territory under British protection, and the Boers were ordered to leave. Basutu land was later annexed to the Cape Colony in 1871, but became separate again as a crown colony in 1884, when it became one of the three British High Commission territories in Southern Africa. Swaziland, now Eswatini, and Bechuanaland, now Botswana, were the other two. By becoming a protectorate, Basutoland and its inhabitants were not subjected to the apartheid regime, and so generally were left to themselves under the more benevolent British rule. The former independent African Mountain Kingdom lost much of its most productive land in what was to become later the Orange Free State to the Boers, and it lost its political autonomy to the British. Later, there were moves by the British to include Lesotho into the Union of South Africa, which had hoped to get control of the region. But the Sotho were unified in their vehement opposition to incorporation into South Africa. With decolonization sweeping through Africa in the 60s, Bechuanaland and Basutoland became independent in 1966 and became known as the Republic of Botswana and the Kingdom of Lesotho, followed in 1968 by Swaziland, which later became Eswatini. For a country to annex another, the following factors have to be considered underlined. First is resources. There are no resources in Lesotho which South Africa does not have more of, apart from water, which South Africa already owns via the Lesotho Highlands Water Project, which is the main exporter of water to South Africa. The second factor is geographic location. Let's use the annexation of Crimea by Russia to illustrate this. The Sevastopol ports and the access to the Black Sea and Mediterranean were totally controlled by Ukraine's physical ownership of Crimea. Therefore, Russia had a pressure to ensure total control of the land. This, however, does not apply in South Africa's case. Lesotho has only one border, which is all South Africa. Eswatini allows access to Mozambique, which South Africa has direct access to via the far more developed entry of Komati Port. Next, we have political or ideological differences. Some analysts consider Lesotho as a satellite state of South Africa, as they are almost completely aligned in every sector. Lesotho depends on South Africa for most of its economic affairs, and its foreign policy is often aligned with that of Pretoria. Both are member states of the Commonwealth of Nations, the Southern African Customs Union, and the Southern African Development Community. They use the South African rand as legal currency, South Africa sets the monetary policy, and Lesotho's loti currency is pegged to the rand. The final factor is people. When Hitler annexed the Sudetenland, he claimed that his only reason was to unite the German people into one land. This cannot happen in South Africa, as, correct me if I'm wrong, there is no single South African culture. For instance, they have 11 official languages. Their national anthem is essentially two songs sung in five languages. South Africa can't claim to be uniting the Basotho under one nation when already they are united under one leader. So there you go, guys, that is how Lesotho has managed to stay as a sovereign nation separate from South Africa. Our desire to inspire a passion for learning about Africa runs deep. If you'd like to support the channel to continue producing more high-quality content on a regular basis, please head over to patreon.com/raisinafrica. That's patreon.com/raisinafrica. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.